people. Welcome to the General Banter Podcast. 420.
424.
424. Post Amsterdam review.
Uh-huh.
Sober as fuck.
As judges.
Full of coffee.
That's us half it.
That's probably a bit too loud. Yeah, apologies to anybody who was you know, had high hopes. And of course, it keeps playing. Anyone who had high hopes of us doing a podcast in Amsterdam, it fucking...
Wishful thinking.
It just didn't...
Feel right, did it?
It didn't materialise, you know, and anytime we had a bit of downtime in the hotel room, it was sleeping.
Aye.
We're gonna go back to this hotel room. No one had the time or the wish to sit down for an hour and talk, you know, and we weren't going to do it in public. You know what I mean?
It was just try
and do it somewhere. It was eventful.
It was. I mean, I would say, just as a sort of preemptive apology, or maybe postemptive. I don't know what emptive means, but it's very rare, Colin, would get to just relax. We're always work.
I think that has a lot to do with it. Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
And I'm not one for, you know, these fucking content creator type people could just power on through and be like, "Well, what's up, dude?"
No,
not for me.
Fuck that.
You gotta feel. It's gotta feel organic. And also, I didn't want to be like, "Guys, can you get together here for a second?
Aye.
Let's talk here."
Aye.
It would have ruined the crack.
It was good crack.
I mean, we'll tell you everything that happened right now. Is probably what we'll do. So basically, we decided to go to Amsterdam. Fucking McCann said he'd never been. You'd been for like a day.
Right.
And I was like, let's go. And then we booked it and fucking went. I didn't drink the whole time.
And I drank the entire time.
And boy, did I make up for it in weed. Here's what happened. We go to the fucking airport. Everyone recognized us. We're very famous.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Incredibly famous.
I was like, I'm not going to drink this whole trip. I'll treat myself, number one. I'll buy some new headphones. Bought some new headphones.
Yeah.
Off a guy, and he got a photo because we're famous as shit. You know, everywhere we go.
Yeah. I got a free massage today for being famous as shit.
Are you serious?
Sorry, God.
Girl or man?
Man.
Oh, yeah. What the fuck? He a fuck, man.
Good looking, though. Good looking, man.
On your back, I suppose.
On my back, yeah.
Did he give you it free after?
He gave me two free in advance. He's basically like...
What did he say?
He's all fucking just saying, I'll come in next week and give you another one.
Thanks
very much.
Is it his own place?
Active therapy clinic lurking. No, I don't think so. Probably get them in trouble, to be honest with you. But... Probably won't work there next week. There'll be some guy going, give me money.
Apologies to Darren for his recent fucking... you call it? Unemployment.
Poor creator. Sponsored my big pimply back with no money. I don't have back pimples, actually. It's the one bit of me that doesn't. Keep talking there. What happened?
Was he getting laid into that trap, was he?
Honey trap, I call it.
Did he tell you, was he like, this originates probably in your calves or something like that?
No, he basically went, your back doesn't bend.
Yeah. You have the flexibility of a...
A staunch loyalist.
An obese bulldog.
Yeah.
If I had to describe your body, I'd say bulldog.
I would go more staff. Yeah, you're right. Actually, bulldog would be bang on, wouldn't it?
Staffy is a bit.
The staffy can still run.
Staffy is a bit of mobility.
Aye.
Mine's without it. I've said it before many times. Mine is a rhino. Like I definitely have.
But you're very flexible. A rhino's flexible.
Well, they're probably deceptively like athlete. That's my body. Like if I got in that position, that's my body. That's my legs.
Yeah.
Isn't it? That's my tiny feet on my fat leg. You know,
haven't seen you in your pants in Amsterdam. Yeah, that is exactly the same size as your leg.
Same color.
Your tail's in the same place too.
Yeah, that's true. Same sort of skin.
You never done eating grass.
On that trip,
and the Serengeti.
Fuck it.
I just got that there. I mean, no.
Anyway, we go to Amsterdam. We'll just play by play it.
Yeah,
we're
in the airport first. We're in the airport.
In the airport.
I was. My thought process was: do you know what? There's going to be a load of weed being smoked. Probably, you don't really need to drink that much. And then got to the airport about 2 hours before we really had to be there. And I believe I texted you an hour and said, I'll be at the bar if you need me.
And you were. And, you know, if you're going into a busy place and you want to find someone, sometimes you text them and go, where are you? Where are you?
Mm.
And I was like, I know where he is.
Fed and Water's closing in the other bar.
And of course he was in the queue.
Yep.
For the bar. The girl that served me was at the gig in Lorne when I came back.
Oh, cool.
How weird is that? Anyway, so yeah, went there. Went to Amsterdam. Got off. Got in a Tesla with a guy.
Yeah.
Had a funny conversation in there.
about Teslas.
He's like, there seems to be making noise. And it's funny because he was
needs
trying to,
maintenance.
He was trying to talk cars to Aaron, but Aaron knows nothing about Aaron. Like, Aaron knows less than me, and I know nothing.
Yeah.
So the guy
also
thought,
refuses to change his accent when he's talking to people from different countries.
Fuck me, Tesla, how's she running?
Was she being, is this a diesel that carries it?
And then fucking, it was so funny because the guy starts talking about it's so quiet, but it makes noise at the front, and like, and he started talking about like suspension and fucking dampeners and all that shit. And the mechanic's staring at him, and he thought that he just didn't understand his English. So the guy starts like trying to further explain the mechanics of this fucking electric car. No, that's why I say the rubber is the them.
Mechanics, what you rubber? You say I understood that.
Anyway, no one wants to hear about this. We got to the hotel.
Yeah.
We went out drinking.
Went out to eat lovely food, first of all.
Lovely
food. Hall, lovely
went
food.
Went to the food hall. It's the sort of place where, to sum you up, I walked in and went, fuck, isn't this place great? And you're like halfway through a pulled pork bap. And I was like, how the fuck?
Where'd you even get that?
How did you buy and eat that so quickly?
And like, I was in one of the free dispensers pointing at a bin.
Everywhere else you buy everywhere else you buy food, and they're like, it's going to be a 10-minute wait or something. And you turn around, Mickey's like, sauces, please. I know what he's fucking on about. And then it was pleasant. I think we were legitimately just enjoying. It was like the most fucking Isle Boy holiday of all time.
Such like really sunny day.
I thought it was going to be
fucking beer garden.
Litzville. And it was like, no, this will do us rightly. It was absolutely...
But I think as well, see the amount of people that were like, fuck, can you imagine being on that flight? Fucking, I don't know what kind of reputation we have, but I think what a lot of people don't know is because you're a comedian, I mean, you can get as fucked as you want any day of the week. Mm-hmm. So going to Amsterdam to get fucked up isn't necessarily...
Yeah, you don't need to like blow off steam.
Yeah.
You have a constant release of steam.
Exactly.
It's called your asshole. Aaron had a shit in the plane.
Forgot about that.
And he didn't even like, you know, most people would be like, okay, I've left it long enough, I'm absolutely desperate, I'll go and fucking knock this out quickly. He was away for about 20 minutes.
Aye.
The flight's only an hour. But he come back and he's like, well, here, boys, should've left that for the grind.
he was busting before we got on the plane. And I could see from the back of his head during the safety briefing, you could see from the back of his head, he was like, I need a shit real bad. That thing goes down, I don't give a fuck.
That fucking jack, his head was the width of the seat.
Aye, fuck, he's a big unit.
He's so big. I never noticed until I seen him on a plane. Also, I was sitting beside the two fattest cons of all time.
Me and Arne.
the way over, there was the fucking hell. And like, I'm aware that I'm quite big and wide, but these two were just like...
Oh, well, there's nothing worse than a proper fucking donut spillover. Like.
Yeah. Oh yeah, it was so fucking... Yeah. And you're like, where's my seatbelt? And you're like, I know it's caught in one of these flaps.
Aye. Of the car in the flap.
Disgusting. And then, so anyway, we go, we fucking eat, we're chilling out. We decided to like bar hop. I'm still not drinking, but I'm absolutely chilling, bro.
Aye.
Just chilling. We're doing a bunch of shit, you know, fucking just bar to bar, just hopping bar to bar. And then we eventually were like, right, I think it's time we made our way to some sort of coffee shop here and got some weed.
Yeah.
I can't remember what, we're near a Bulldog Cafe, which was like a big spot. Probably the biggest one I've seen. That was huge, that place.
It was the Bulldog Hotel, though, wasn't it?
Oh, was it? Okay.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. And then, so we're, I walked in, right? I have a limited knowledge of weed. And I was like, let me look down this list. Oh, yeah. I've seen Lemon Haze before.
Aye.
Right?
And Aaron's going, that original OG Kush. OG Kush. Get that OG. Malachi's cousin.
I don't even know if there was OG Kush, because I probably would have got that, because at least I recognized the name. But I fuck it. I was like, right, Lemon Haze, I've definitely had that before. Let's get that. And they give you, you know, you buy it by the gram. So about a gram of that. And I'm sure we put a gram.
In the one joint? There definitely was.
In the one joint. Badly rolled it up. And we basically...
It looked like an ice cream cone. It was fucking massive.
We basically fucking relayed this joint.
Yeah.
In about 90 seconds until it was gone.
Initially, I was going, I'm not going to... I'm just going to stick to the pints today. I was like, I'm going to stick to the pints until later on. Because... It'll just fucking put me to sleep. And then I got all jealous. I was like, fucking give me up.
But it was so funny because the dude that hooked me up with the weed vapes, I was going back and forth talking to him, and I hadn't responded to a message. And he goes, oh, sure, I'm sure you're busy and you're in Amsterdam. And then I told him what had happened. I was like, we got a fucking gram of Lemon Haze and I crushed it up and put it all in one joint. And he was like, oh my fucking God. And I was like, I had to go back to the hotel. I was completely freaking out. And he goes, I'm surprised you could walk to the fucking hotel. He goes, that would fucking kill you. And I was like, yeah, no, fuck me. And then, but like. That was only the first of it. Like we fucking, we walked out and we're all like, oh, that's funny. Walking down the street, having a wee giggle. And it just, it literally like was just clicking to the top of a roller coaster. And then it was just like fucking, we...
And I feel like we only walked about 10 feet away from the actual place where we smoked it.
Oh my God, we walked like, it was like 15 meters around the corner, I'd say. But it felt like you were fucking, you know, you had like two kettlebells tied to your ankles. I was like, oh, fucking hell, bro.
It hit me, we sat down on those wee benches because Aaron needed a piss. And he's all like, we're getting cocktails, I need a piss.
But this is how high we were. How confusing was it that he was just standing outside and then we were standing for about 5 minutes and I was like, why are we here?
Aye.
And he's like, oh, toilet's locked. But it took like 10 minutes to get that out of him. We're just standing there. And then that fucking guy.
I was convinced there was a guy and a girl that both worked there out having a smoke. So I was like, let's sit up there. And I was like, can I sit here? And the guy was like, you can also shit over there. And I was like, nah, I'll just sit here. But turns out that guy didn't work there. He was literally just outside having a cigarette. And
yeah, and you thought he was in the
fucking 16 stone fucking paddy. He was all, move, cunt. Like,
and then we're,
daddy need to lie down.
Trying to explain that we're from Northern Ireland and all. And this guy just like, he's like, I've watched some episodes of Friends. Yeah. He's like, Theresa May, you guys are fucked.
You guys are fucked.
You guys are fucked.
And as he's saying that, we're going, we probably are fucked, you know.
And I must have had like stranger danger face that a kid has when they see someone they don't like. I was just like, you know, like we fried him. It feels like, I don't like him. Take him away. And then from then on, it was just like, and then you've got fucking cocktails.
Yeah.
You got two, what were they?
Moscow Mules or something.
Oh my God. And then you were drinking them. And we got a seat and it was full of families and everything. And we're sitting at this thing and I've never felt bigger and more awkward.
Oh my God.
I was trying to like squeeze past these wee rickety like wicker chairs and all. And excuse me.
And we were the three people that you would see. If you were on a family holiday and you seen us three, you'd be like fucking animals.
Yeah.
Because we were just howling, laughing.
Yeah. And knocking shit over.
Yeah. Chain smoking fags. Fucking talking about dicks and jinnies.
But it was so... it was ridiculous because you get that like... You know, you get like... Oh, you get that initial like, oh, fuck, I'm stoned. And then you get the real like... I spot everywhere that. Like, I'm pretty fucking high. And then you're like, okay, this will carry on for a minute and then it'll die off. This just kept... like clicking into different gears. Did we go for pizza?
After... Yeah, so when...
Did we walk away and come back to the same spot? Is that what happened?
No. I don't know. No, I think we just got up to go get food. And then we're like, I think the plan was we'll take a wee walk. We'll go look at,
we'll see if we
look at a few hours or something. And then, yeah, went to the pizza place. Aaron went for another piss somewhere, I think.
See, at this point, my brain felt like I was in a fucking tumble dryer.
Aye.
I couldn't focus on anything. I literally, you know, I was walking along. I was like, I don't know why I'm here or what the fuck's going on. I was like, what's going on here? And then at some point, I must have just tried to communicate, like, take me back to the hotel. Take me. So
it was like, me and Aaron were both going, I think the fact that we're drinking is probably just... Excuse me, like keeping it at bay or whatever. Mm-hmm. You don't, like your brain's going, well, you're clearly getting fucked up, so I know how to handle it.
For sure.
But what I was keeping secret was I was paranoid as fuck.
Yeah.
So you were like, I need to go back to the hotel. In my head, I was going, they're going to go back to the hotel and wait until I fall asleep and then go out without me. But the whole time going, you all right, mate? You feel okay?
And I was just like, get me home. Home now. And I was just fucking, I was on like a 2-second fucking memory loop.
Aye.
I would just be like, oh yeah, I know what we're doing. Oh no, where are we? Oh Jesus, why am I doing? And then we're in that pizza place. And I sat down and was like, this will save me. I'll eat something and I'll fucking sober up a bit. And I lifted this bit of pizza and it weighed 30 kilos. I was like, like trying to put it in my mouth. And you know, you're like, I was so fucking high that I was like, I had no feeling in my head. I was like, I'm chewing it. And I'm like, have I swallowed that properly? I was like, I have no... It's like, I have no idea what that is. Is that in my mouth or is it in my stomach? Like, I can breathe. Oh, fuck that. And then at one point, I was just like, I have to get out of here. Like, but I think we just absolutely completely miscalculated it.
Yeah.
We smoked like
a gram of weed.
Yeah. Well, in fucking 90 seconds. It was literally like the fucking cops were coming. There was a fuck here. Fuck. Jesus Christ.
I think I aren't at the roach.
Oh my God. We were fucking smashed. And then.
And even see, whenever you got up, I was like, go fuck up. He's all right. And then. I realized you weren't coming back and just ate your pizza today. But Cam's over his car. I don't fucking know.
He might be dead, but sure. Waste not, want not.
We'll find him.
That's so funny because like... Cause I walked out of the shop and I was like, where did you go to the toilet? And he went... I mean, it's so funny. Like, how did I not barf? Because most people are like, oh, I'm white eating. And I definitely was at that point where it was like anything could have fucking happened. But someone said, oh, I went to the toilet in the McDonald's, and I walked out and looked at the McDonald's, and it might as well have been fucking like 200 miles away. I was like, no, that's not happening. I'll just stand outside this Starbucks with my hands like just fucking weird. And then we go back to the hotel. You know, I was out of my mind, but I could tell that yous were out of your mind, but also like, is this, are we doing this? Are we really going back? And we're like, yeah, we gotta go fucking back. And we go back to this. Now, meanwhile, Amsterdam buildings, because they're all so like tight together and high, the fucking stairs are like, what was it not like?
They're
not
even fucking, there wouldn't be the width of your foot. You had to go.
Oh my God. Yeah. You could, what part of your foot do you put on there? Yeah.
So trying to get up with the three of us, and I remember going up, you and Arne were almost like fucking, I don't know if you were in front or Arne was in front. But whatever,
I think I was in the middle.
Yeah. Well, whatever. Yeah. So you must have been concentrating on Arne's feet because you were both like doing the same sort of stepping. And I was like, oh, that seems to be a good idea. And then I started giggling a wee bit about the fact that we were all walking in sort of like that close together in single file, like fucking. Tuff, tuff, tuff.
Yeah.
So I stopped walking. And then as soon as I stopped walking, I was like, oh, why did I do that? And I had to fucking think about this. Like, I had to figure out how to get back up the stairs again. Like, fuck.
I know. It was a fucking disaster. And then we went into the room and I was like, I just, you know, when you're like, tunnel vision, like I just need to fucking lie down. And I was so paranoid. I was like, this high has got just worse and worse and worse and worse. And then I started to think like, oh shit, there's a balcony in this room. And I was like, what if I just get so high that I don't know what I'm doing and just jump off a balcony? And then, and of course, I'm obviously, you know, with it enough to think like, that I'm like, well, just don't go near the thing, just if you're going to the bathroom. And I was literally like getting up and just charging to the bathroom and being like sitting in the toilet going, please don't fucking like just decide I want to go out there for fresh air and fall over. And I would open the door and just charge back in the bed.
And then like a monster was gonna get you.
And then the funny thing was, yeah, like my own brain was gonna get me. And then the worst thing was, you two fucking went to sleep immediately. And all I could hear was like, like all these different snores. And I'm just lying there going, don't get jump off the balcony. Not even in like a, not in like a suicidal, like I want to kill myself. It was literally like, I hope I don't get high enough where I just think that I can jump off it. Yeah. So it's like fucking, and then I just lay there for about 3 hours and you slept the whole way through. And then eventually we got up and then by the time we're heading out, I was like, oh, it's me nice and stoned now, boys. I was like, that's a nice wee toastiness to have on it. And then we went to the fucking, that Thai place again, which I talked about before, which was ridiculous.
That was class. That was really nice.
And I love Thai people, or any Southeast Asians, very blunt.
Aye.
We close in 20 minutes.
Order quickly.
Quickly. She hands you the fucking menu. What you want?
Aye. What have we had more drinks in there too, didn't we?
Yeah, beers, I think.
No, we'd be cocktails.
Oh, yeah, that's right, yeah. But if...
Because I was getting a wee bit more kind of like, when you've had a load of pints, then you get up.
Yeah.
You're like,
yeah,
I'm gonna have to get fucking back on the beer here to try and function.
Back in the beer,
back
mate.
Fucking
back on the beers.
And back on what I did get.
What do we do that night? So did we smoke more weed out?
Smoke more weed. Went and bought.
What do we do?
Went to a sex show that night.
I know, but where did we get the weed? Do we buy White Widow or something?
Yeah, because remember we walked along the red light after we got some food.
Mm-hmm.
And then me and you kept trying to talk Arne into booking a prostitute, but he wouldn't do it.
How interesting is it seeing people get knocked back from prostitutes?
That was, yeah.
That's fucking fascinating to me. This wee fucking short black dude goes up and the guard's like, nah, bro.
Not the day.
But there was a few that, it gave me a wee confidence.
Yeah, oh, definitely, yeah.
Because we're walking past, they're like, hey, come in.
The three bags, he's coming.
Fucking, you wouldn't see the end of it. I don't know why you and McCann didn't buck someone. Like
McCann should have.
McCann was literally like, no, I'd rather just eat cheesecake in bed, right, which he did.
We were like, but we'll give you the money. Just tell us what it's like.
And by the way, I saw this guy go up and the girl was like, absolutely unfathomably hot. And she's like, €50. And I was like, is that the goal? Is that the goal? What, for a foot job? 50? I'd be like, you're 200.
It is. It was.
Get in that ass.
It's very tempting to go in and just have a wee look around the room. That's where you work.
Yeah.
Where do you take your tea? Do you have a canteen and all?
There are a few. I mean, it is ridiculous. You walk past a few and you're just like, what is
I'm convinced we saw a bunch of them on their way home from work as well.
Yeah.
Very normal looking when there's no red lights and they've got clothes on.
Oh, I've seen that before. No. I've been at a fucking cabaret type show and someone's mate or something was going out. There were a couple, the two of them were in this thing, and the girl was on stage 1 minute. I think it's the smoke and mirrors and the lights. Right. I think she was dancing about and she was like in good, like really good athletic shape, like ripped and fucking tassels on her wee titties. And then after, she was just like in a tracksuit with no makeup on. And you would never have went.
You wouldn't recognize her.
Yeah. If someone had to be like, oh yeah, she was just on stage. And I was like, oh, what? You serious? Right. Like, I just had no idea. I think it's probably like that.
Yeah.
They probably just knock off, put a fucking Adidas tracksuit on, way smoke home. A fag outside, and you would just not pay them any attention. Just
hang their kegs up.
I'll wash it tomorrow. There was a few of them where you're just like...
There was one that was in the same window. Like on a corner. We walked past her twice. And I remember the second time we walked past her, I was getting excited hoping she was still there.
No, Mick.
And she was fucking...
Let me guess. Was it the one with the giant fake tits?
No, giant real tits.
Oh.
They looked like real tits to me anyway. But I didn't get up close enough. The glass was in the way. I was all...
Your lip all up like that.
Making steam like a velociraptor in Jurassic Park. Do you pay any cash on you?
I've said this before, but I wish there was a few that were a bit like normalized. It's all very high end and slutty and like porno. Like if there was one girl in just like leggings and a fucking white vest.
There was one that I thought was, I would nearly give her money just because she was good crack. She was drinking a bottle of Coke. We looked at her. She put the Coke on her fanny and humped it like she had a dick. And I was like, jeez, fucking dude. Give her a spelt in Lavery's. That's funny as fuck.
That's good banter.
Well done, you,
Pat. Her only problem for you was she was on the second floor.
I don't think any of us were getting upstairs at that. Like.
Although, do you remember there was like a second floor one and there was like a black girl that looked like she walked straight off a fucking Snoop Dogg video?
Aye.
McCann was like, ugh, grabbing his pee-pee.
I was interested.
But you're just like, Aaron, get in there.
I know.
Go on up in there.
But it's a weird, even though it's legal over there and stuff, it is a weird fucking morality. I wouldn't be in it. I have to do a bit of curtain before I can even fucking spend 50 euro, if you know what I'm saying. Because
I think it's less weird than like
going with somebody in a bar.
Just meeting someone and banging them in the toilet. I actually think it's less weird than that.
Aye, maybe.
Because it's all the cards are on the table.
Aye.
You know what I mean?
Credit cards.
You literally take card Visa.
Can I PayPal you this?
There was one dude, we were walking along and they if a guy goes up, they get whipped in and then they shut the curtain. And I was walking past, the curtain went back and the door opened. She pushed this guy back out on the street and he walked. He was like fucking Daniel Craig. He literally looked like James Bond. Aye. And I was like, how's he not
slinging it?
Sweating and like one sock on and fucking he come out like ding, ding, ding,
ding. They're probably just fucking very good at what they're doing, just wank you off before you even.
Yeah, that's probably
they're probably that good at hand jobs. You're like, that's me, and they're like, that's you.
That's probably the trick. You're like, hey baby, what's the guy? And they're just doing some magic trick and you're like, are we gonna get to the
thanks for your time.
Yeah, and then they just fucking hoof you out.
I probably don't even have fannies.
Like if you think about it, did it say somewhere like 15 that your slot is like 15 minutes? Like, if nothing happens in 15 minutes, you're out.
I've heard that from people.
Who?
Like, mates of mine that have been over before.
You've 15 minutes?
Yeah.
That's pretty swift turnaround, like.
Oh, definitely.
Turn around and fucking bend it over.
But is it 15?
You've done that before in your lifetime minutes? Where you know you're like, you're about to fucking, oh, I'll go to that, and then a bit of sexing happens, and you're like, fuck me, that was like 50 minutes.
Not once in my life.
You're like, I'm late now.
I'm a punctual lover.
Time flies when you're having...
Bum.
Come.
No, because I've often wondered, if it's 15 minutes, right, is that
15? I've often wondered.
Well, as I sit upon the hustings, I muse to oneself, many bucks do you get in 15 minutes? Like,
no, it's as soon as
is
you,
it 15 minutes no, and soon, one blast, or yeah, is it you, fucking... No,
it's like...
Because I'm a quick reloader.
It's like, when you do a gig and it's like the door split versus the guaranteed fee. It's like, if you're blowing loads after 6 minutes, you're right.
Aye.
It don't matter. That's the goal. Yeah, because you'd be like, listen, there's two rounds in this.
In this it's double barreled.
Let me click it over to the left nut for you.
I had a busy day. No, well, let me lick out a wee bit to get myself reared up again.
I can't believe no one bucked anyone. That's shocking. Like, I was upset. Like, I mean, if anything, you've fucking 10 new minutes of material.
If you buck a prostitute, it's like you can't fuck it. Well,
you can't talk about it on stage.
No, I don't know. Could you? I don't know. I talk about bucking all the time. I suppose if anybody was going to have 10 minutes, it would have been me.
The thing is, it's like
Yeah, I think if I booked a prostitute, I'd have more minutes to stand up than I would have had actual booking. I'll take you through this minute by minute. Well, that's us now.
Here's in real time. You could do it in an open spot.
You're doing an MCing.
Here in real time is my full...
Last act was talking about hers there. And
Mickey mentioned hers.
I booked her once. Anyway, next up.
Just everyone has the same story. Oh, fuck me. It's so funny. Like,
and then we went, well, that was... went to the first section.
It is weird. It's like... it's not like you're doing charity work, but you're like, that's their job. Like, they want...
Yeah, because I don't think...
they want people to come in.
Is Amsterdam... is it the same as, like, in Australia, where there wouldn't be as much, like, fucking trafficking and shit involved in it? It's kind of... they're like, you can just be a sex worker.
Oh, wow, you're fucking... I mean, there will be, like, an accountant who deals just with prostitutes, probably. Aye. In fact, I seen that on something. What did I see that on? Mickey.
My sunburn.
Oh, sorry. There is a fucking show on Channel 4. We'll get back to fucking this bullshit in a minute. There is a show on Channel 4 called Very British Brothel, and it is...
exactly what you think.
Oh my... it's like if fucking Peter Kay did one of those shows where he like fucking... you want to see these fucking animals? I swear to God. I nearly might stop this and find it and download it and cut the best bits out of it. I'll see if I can get any clips on there. Oh, shut up. Ryan Cullen getting in touch there. Shout out to Ryan Cullen.
Very funny man.
Brothel. So basically they're in Sheffield, right?
Oh.
So they're right northern. Let me just... this is just a clip. Hold on. It's fucking beautiful.
Hi,
like,
Ryan.
Hi. Hello.
Until the motorhome is operating.
And they keep doing these things. Like,
the motorhome.
They're like, what are the most popular women?
Are that 3 minutes that you get out of a restaurant?
Mick, you have to watch this. They're like, what are the most popular workers? Sarah's name is like fucking Sarah or something. And sorry to use your sister's name.
Storage. She's out of a job with the money.
But there's this... fuck me. They're like, one of our popular workers, fucking Janice or whatever. And they're like, she gets up to 15 customers a day. And she is a fucking warlock. Like,
really?
Built like a fucking shit house. They're all big fat bitches with no teeth.
Look at this fucker here.
And they start really early in the morning because... you know, people are like wanting the buck. We're going to go hard on. And there's like, and Tina here, she goes on the breakfast run and comes back with all this shit. And then it cuts to this fat bitch eating chicken curry on chips. She's like, chicken curry on chips, breakfast of champions.
Jesus
and she's
Christ.
Eating that. And then she's like, all right, Dave, it'll be 2 seconds. And she like finishes eating the curry chip and then like fucking waddles in. And then one of the dudes has like a food fetish. So she runs him upstairs and then she comes stomping back down in these heels. She's like, oh, forgot a few things. Reaches under the fucking counter there. And there's like, 3 giant sort of economy tins of custard, and she's run a bath up there and they're outside the door and all you can hear is that and she's fucking slapping this custard about, and then the guy leaves like fucking pulling his trousers out. All right, thanks Janice, see you next week. And she's like, he comes in, he just likes being cut fucking custard all over the place, and then runs squeegeeing it back into the bath and all. It's fucking... and then it's run by like this woman and her daughter, and they're always coming up with these things. Like, we've had a few requests for a glory hole, and so she has like the fucking handyman in, like, and they're like measuring, like, I think that's about right. Like, chilling the dick through. And then she tells this story where she's like, she goes, the fella came in, put his dick through. I was frightened. It was about that long, big massive cock. And that, you know, did whatever happened, happened. And then she went downstairs, cleaned herself up or whatever. And I went back up about 10 minutes later. He's knocking on the door. I had locked him in for 10 minutes. Watch this clip. Look at this fucking... that's her there. Christ. She looks... and I say this all the time, but I'm deadly serious. Looks like me in fucking like sexy gear.
Regular clients.
This guy's got his gut hack.
This is me, Wesley Snipes. Alfred.
Some are regular, as in they come Monday, Wednesday, Friday every week. Some irregular.
She owns it, and if with a set of braces, she would actually be probably not bad looking.
They come once a month. Some customers.
This guy, put your fucking belly away, mate. Like, Jesus Christ.
I mean, how did he get put on the leather jacket, put on the jobber that doesn't go over his gut, and then put on this scarf that is like half a tea towel? And he's like,
Must not forget me in the leather jacket.
That's my Wesley Snipes. That's what he said.
Every time they come to visit family, which is like twice a year, they come in here twice a year.
Hiya.
The girls are happy to accommodate most requests to keep their clients happy.
I have one guy who likes me just to sit there and have a cigarette, and I sit there in very sexy underwear and I have a smoke. Another request was, could I eat three pizzas and then would I measure your stomach, see if you've got any bigger?
Am I a prostitute?
I could do it, no problem.
I love these girls. This is this thing about women. Like, she is a fucking pig.
She's not pretty.
You know what I mean?
She looks like Woodsy. She...
Give us a shout, hey, if you like.
They pages.
But someone's gonna buck her, you know what I mean? I'll fucking wee scarf.
Some guys will come in and you think, oh, he's fit. And then when you get him upstairs, he's got his mother's knickers and tights on under his jeans, and it's like, all right then.
I remember saying to one of
those teeth, though.
Oh my god.
I love your bra. Where did you get that from? It was gorgeous.
1 in 10 British men admit to paying for sex, and there is no age limit.
I am surprised by some ages at men, because I thought once you went to 40, 50, that were it. But at 91, they're still coming in.
Pull the door, love. Hey, lovey. Do you want to drink a tea?
This might be Captain Custard here.
I always like to go straight up with Jim.
Just go straight with Jim.
Do you know what else bothered me about this? There's too much tea going on. Like, throughout the whole thing, I was like,
John, brew.
Let me finish my brew. I'll get up. You know, like tea breath?
Aye.
Let me give you a big sticky tea breath blowjob.
Fucking hell.
I'll just finish my brew. John, a brew. They're going up the buck.
Do you take sugar?
They have a cup of tea each. Oh, hang about. Do you get me finish me fucking tea? It's going cold.
Bring them cups down when you're finished.
And make sure run a Brillo around it or it'll stain. It looks all right to me. No, I'm in my asshole.
Hello.
63.
And also another entertaining bit is all of these fucking wheels getting off this sofa. Oh my god.
Old Owen is another of Joe's regulars.
Would you like to follow me, honey?
Yes.
Look at the...
He's...
I like a big arse, but I mean...
Aye, that's...
Wait for an hour in the VIP suite.
That's not a buy, bro. McCann would pay hard dollar for that fucking jacket.
No.
Fetishes some people have got are quite interesting.
She's
You're 30, one of them.
She's 31, apparently. 31 stone. There she is. Way up the stairs with 3 tins of custard.
Pie. Apple pie. Don't they make a mess up those stairs? I won't, honey. I like to think I'm quite experimental. There's not anything really that I can think of that I've had to say no to or sort of think about. Not as yet,
the
anyway.
Atkins didn't like that.
Except vegetables. Fuck no.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus,
the guy's from here. Far away from
even after 6 years, you...
Oh, Jesus, get the custard round me. Oh, fuck, I'm a dirty big apple pie.
Wait a second, I've seen it all, or heard it all, and then another customer will come in, and it'll be another story.
Thank you very much, hon.
Jesus, I'm bros, they don't be buying the good stuff.
Fucking hell.
Quite a few people with food fetishes, to be honest. Like to throw custard all over you. And that's about it, really. That's his thing. Custard, nothing else, just custard.
Sexy
I don't know
MP.
If it's the smell, the colour, what it is. He loves it.
She's a fucking tank. Nah.
I'll be watching that
the
as
best,
soon as I get home.
Some of the best fucking TV. There's another one, Strippers. I think I might have seen that too. I couldn't believe my luck when I switched that on. And then this woman here, she owns it. And like she literally is like a Peter Kay character. She's like, all right, today we're out looking, and she's got like a squint, and she's like, today we're out looking at mobile home, budget of $6,000, and we're looking for something, a separate bedroom, and something for the women to clean themselves up in, but also they're going to have a bit of sex in the back, and I'll do the driving. I'll go around country, pull up like a fucking ice cream man.
I haven't got license yet, but I'm working on it.
We're working on it, working on it. Left-hand drive, you know, cross that bridge and we'll come to it.
I got the idea once when I got fingered in back at the ambulance.
Nino.
London's burning, so's me lines.
We couldn't afford it, so I've downgraded to a hearse, but you can lie flat
if you want to go prison style, there'll be no doggy, not enough headroom. Unless you want to hang out back. You know, put their fucking hatch back up and slide in.
Open boot.
I'll be honest with you, lost the money. We've got a grand, so we've got a trailer. It's fucking on back at trailer.
Bought 2-man tent, put it up in the living room. That great outdoors experience, you know.
I'll be honest with you, got bored, and if we just bought a large raincoat, then we just both fuck under the raincoat. I don't know what accent.
Got a bin bag and a big ruler.
We just built a den.
I got a load of cushions.
Have you ever fucked anyone in a Wendy house? It's great. Shove your ass out a little window. Put your dick down chimney.
You play a really funny game. You make it look like Peppa Pig's talking.
Oh my fucking days. Honestly, watch that. Best show I've ever seen. Well,
that's fucking...
I have a sore head and I've laughed that hard. Jesus Christ.
So I Amsterdam went.
Honestly, the bit where they do the glory hole, they've fucked it up the first time and they have it lower home.
Well, the thing is, yeah. Our fucking our Andy man, blind Tony.
Blind no hands Tony, you know him.
And she did it and she was like, how do we test it out? Someone put their dick through that. Incredible.
Excuse me, Graham. If I knock a five off, you put your cock through that hole. My name's Charlene. Oh, sorry.
Free session. Let me measure your cock height. unbelievable. Anyway, so we'll go. Let's go back. Let's go back to. By the way,
that's way better than anything we didn't answer.
I know. Fucking hell.
That's what we're looking for. You know, I had like Thailand standards going to. Did we go to a sex show that first night?
Yeah.
Which one was that? The one where we sat at the back?
Yeah, the shit one.
By the way, Asian Central.
Asian guys.
It seems to just be a lot of people from like slightly oppressed countries.
I think as well, because especially for like the like Eastern Asian, as in the Chinese, Japanese, I mean, all their daddies and families are blurred out. So they're probably just glad to see a real one.
Probably, yeah. Now, what I will say is it's very, you know,
it's very camp.
It's very camp, but it's also like, it's, you know, it's dark and there's like a couple of lasers and it's all very, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
If you're looking to see some blurt, you're not, go to a strip club or something. You're not really, you're not seeing like much that you want to see.
Yeah.
And a guy comes, I mean, see when they do these like sex shows and the guy's like coming out and fucking just banging, usually to fucking like Pitbull or something like that.
Yeah. Da, Scooter! Da, are you ready? Da, 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 da,
da. And he's just, and they do it to the beat, and the guy could not be more checked out. Like, his fucking, the guy's just like a million miles away, just like, must take out the bins.
Oh, keeping their sunglasses on.
Yeah. Probably asleep behind it.
It was that woman that took the guidelines of a fucking 2-man tent out of her family. Remember that?
Yeah.
In the dark.
We went to that first sex, that was terrible. The first one we went
to. The second one was so bad, it was hilarious.
Yeah, but at least that one had a bit of... Like, the first one was basically like you were in a small nightclub and then people would come up on stage and do a bit of a show. But it was so dark and everything. You were just like, well, I don't even know what the fuck I'm doing here. And then we just left. It was shit. And like after that, what did we do after that? Went and had fucking ice cream?
I don't think we... It was such a... Smashing a load of beers and... Did we smoke another joint, probably? And then went and got loads of fucking dessert.
We switched the strains of weed. So we went from like absolutely fucking... It was like taking acid to just so starving.
Yeah.
We're fucking eating all around us.
Could chew your way through a brick wall.
Oh,
or something.
That's right. We had Thai food, went to sex show, then had chicken. Like a bunch of
fucking wings.
I
forgot about them as well. Aren't
fat cunts. In fact, everyone in that shop sounded like those girls in that video.
Yeah. Are you fucking hot wings for you, fat cunt? Jesus Christ, man.
Jolly, you had a good time, have you? You had a good time. Yeah. Of course you have, so good lad.
Good lad. And then we fucking, I don't know, we just went back to the hotel. And then next morning, woke up, very nice breakfast. It was so, do you know what? We were in such a fucking beautiful, this is such Isle Boy material.
But the honestly, shout out to Maureen for fucking booking the hotel. Because if it had been left us, it would have been.
If anyone wants to stay somewhere, be it, let Maureen book it. But see that, we walked around the corner and we're just sitting having a fucking, the most...
hipster version of a fucking ciabatta I've ever had in my life. But you're just sitting there and you're like, the weather's beautiful. Oh, she's the hottest woman I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah. Look, there's a doggy there.
You know, there's non-stop fucking Mercedes estates going past.
Yeah.
You know? And just...
pretty girls on bikes
giant,
and stuff.
Giant girls on bikes.
Yeah. It was a lovely morning. It was just nice.
Apparently Dutch people are the tallest people in the world.
Really?
And some kind, I did see a guy go past us when we were sitting outside that water hole or whatever it was called. And the dude, like, he was fucking 8 foot on the bike. And I was like, Jesus Christ. But we did that, walked down the street. That's why I put the photo up of you, and everyone was like, are them boys okay?
That's the worst photo that's ever been. I don't even fucking look like that. Well, or do you?
Unfortunately, yes.
There was enough weed in my system that whole, I was going, do I look like that at all times? Or do I have a very different version of what I think I look like?
By the way, the next day after smoking all that weed, I was literally fucking mentally broken.
Aye.
I was walking around just like, I don't feel safe at all. I give myself fucking brain damage. In fact, today is the first day where I'm like,
feeling all right.
I actually feel okay. Walked around, went to that fucking Rijks Museum or whatever it's called, that big fucking square, lay on the grass. Do you smoke more weed there?
Yeah, blaze one up there.
Blaze one up there, and then fucking...
They've got no ice cream.
They've taken away that big Amsterdam sign.
Why? Because you were only...
By the way, for a guy who's been to that place before, but then previously the day before smoked a life-changing amount of weed, standing there going,
Have you done yourself?
I was like, literally got to Google it. I was like, where is the fucking I Amsterdam sign? I'm like, it was there, but there's still all the people. And I was like, hold on a minute, my fucking mind. And I knew I had it in a vlog. I nearly looked the fucking vlog up. But then I was speaking to Frank, and he's like, oh yeah, they moved it because there was just too many fucking people.
Oh, it's just a pain in the ass, yeah.
It was, I mean, if anybody gets a photo of it, like, clean, as in, like, you see the whole sign, they've probably done it at 5 a.m. You can't. That's why I joked on the vlog. Like, I was behind it, and I was like, no one ever checks out the rear end of these fucking these hotspots back of the Taj Mahal, you know, like all that shit. But yeah, they fucking moved it. I don't even know where it went. And then we walked down the street. Did we go back to the food hall then?
Went for a pint. Beers.
I went and got fucking sun cream for you fucking toasty bitches.
Oh, that's right. And then me and Aaron blast a few beers away, and then did we go back for another kip?
I went back to, like, you see, that's a problem. I think what slowed us down a good bit was the fact that the weather was amazing.
Yeah.
Because you just fucking sat. We were just sitting there like, this is unbelievable. I went into that CBD shop, bought some CBD for the crack, and I'm still not convinced.
Oh, really?
I think I only ever once had CBD oil that was good, as in, like, I felt it pretty quickly and it felt good.
Yeah.
All the rest of them, it's just fucking, I don't know what you do. Just take it.
Well, suppose you build up your tolerance of the old ganja too, though, have you? Maybe.
You build up your tolerance.
Who do you think me am?
Must me robe on it. There were so many fucking, like, sayings that just, like, we walk past these Scottish ones. Like, that could nearly become a saying now. You know, like if someone's like, you know, are you drunk yet? You just go, Tresha. I walk past this woman and she just goes, she was explaining to this other woman. I can imagine, like, I don't know, like someone asked her to do something or whatever, and she couldn't do it because she was already blocked. And she was like, all I heard was the sense, Tresha, I'm 3 sheets to the wind. Brilliant. I was literally like, I don't even know that.
We went back on the first, it was we went for that kip after the fucking crazy strong weed as well. Me and McCann took the fit of the giggles.
Yeah.
And McCann went, what was it? Fucking quit that, carry on, sir.
Would you quit that? That's like, every time I see Aaron, there's like 3 more things I can slag him for.
Aye.
And he'd be like, oh, would you stop? Oh, give over, would you give out a rest? He's a fucking...
it was fucking funny.
I was definitely the casualty the first day, but like, fuck me. And then what do? We just went back out.
Yeah.
Went to a different coffee shop. You see, that's what we should have done the first night. Just chill out in a coffee shop.
Aye.
You know, went that Jolly Joker thing, went up there. Dude behind the counters, fucking from Dublin or something. That was hilarious.
Aye. He was kind of sound to me because when we went back in the second time.
Yeah.
He was expecting us to buy more. He was like, well, you could see he was kind of being like, oh, fuck, you're from, you know, get up there. Go on, lie down.
People get, people, like, they're just shoveling out grams of weed.
to anybody, to people like us who are like, oh yeah, I smoke weed. And then you put a full fucking gram in a joint and you kill yourself. And but they're just dishing it out. They don't give a fuck. And I think what they do to regulate it is they don't, some of those places don't sell pre-rolls.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I think they go like, okay, if you can take it and roll a joint yourself, you have some sort of experience in it.
And anyway, I've got a pre-roll as well. There's loads of tobacco in it.
Really?
The first time I went over, there was fucking tons of tobacco in the pre-roll ones.
Well, that's what we started doing. Like, I was smoking a lot of tobacco-based ones. No. But I had no... It didn't really, like, fucking...
Aye, there's no effect on it. Like,
bring it all back. Like, I'm like, oh, I want to smoke fags again. But,
So when did we go? Because when
there must be some victims, I was about to say, because you go in and there's just abandoned, like, you know, like three quarters of a fucking all grass joint, and you're like, someone's taken like four puffs of that and just went, Jesus Christ, the night, and had to fucking bomb it out there.
It was one of them, because we were only there for 2 days as well. You couldn't really go fucking full. You couldn't go as full clip as you if you were there for 4 nights. You'd be like, let's fucking eat something.
I don't know, that one day just went pretty hard. Like,
yeah. I couldn't fucking talk by the end of the second night, remember?
I know you were, I was worried that you were trying to like, you were the way I was, but you probably weren't. It was like a different type of
No, I was dead on. I was just like, I just couldn't be annoyed fucking speaking. I was just like, I'm so fucking stoned.
Yeah. that's that different type. That's that in that fucking like indica weed.
Aye.
You're just wiped out. Remember that girl just fucking sitting there like, I look at people like that.
And she was
like,
just drawn.
I'm like, what are you doing? You weigh about 3 stone.
Aye.
And you're about 19 and you're here by yourself out of your mind.
See that place when we went upstairs and that fucking Jolly Joker as well, the steps were steep as fuck and the banister didn't look great. And I was like, someone's going to take a tumble here. Someone's going to fucking fall.
Yeah.
So the whole time
all
in
three
the place,
of us were going to go through the fucking
I just couldn't wait to get out of it. I was like, I need to get down these steps just so I know I can.
Yeah. And that girl was just like, I think I left it. Is there a joint there? I can't remember. And we were like, is that it? She goes, what?
Yeah. Like,
oh, you just asked me if that was your joint. What did you say? Okay, maybe it is. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm really, really high.
Yeah, she was just drawing on a wee fucking page.
Yeah. Just fucking.
Just fucked.
I mean, it's, I like weed, but then there's some people where you're like, okay, what's this doing for you? You know what I mean? You look in the corner and there's just these two like fucking Indian looking dudes.
Aye.
Oh, and one of them is white, actually. And he's just fucking, they're just like, sitting doing nothing.
Aye.
By the way, shout out to Jolly Joker for having the best playlist of all time.
Oh, fucking cracking playlist.
McCann was in there like, oh shit. Oh shit. Don't do me like that, damn it. It was like fucking, it was like my Sony Ericsson in 2002.
Aye. Bang. It was fucking class.
Lean back.
Not that I could relax because I was just like, we're upstairs, but.
Just fucking panic eating Pringles. Oh my God, I tell you one thing, when you're not drinking alcohol, you replace it with just soft drinks and you're like, oh, I've had 30 Coke Zeros today.
Aye, the three of us went through 2 bog rolls in 24 hours.
I'd say that's pretty, well, that's considering funny. We weren't in the room that much.
Yeah.
That night, did we go back out again?
We went back, had a kip, went back out again. That's when we went to Jolly Joker and went to that fucking thing.
We came back and Mickey fucking like, you know, I said it was like Bruce Almighty when he just like, all his clothes come off. And you were scrambling up those wee steep steps. And then you're like, I was like, do you need a shit? And you're like, oh why? And I got the clip. I might have the fucking clip.
Did you get on your phone?
I might have it. I can't remember.
I was not well.
And you just shut the door and I was like just fucking shit your brains out. Like, oh my God, I wonder, do I have that?
Oh, it was a bad day.
What's that? No. Oh, that was their snore. That was your snoring. And I'm in the fiery depths of a freak out. Like, and I like it. Hold on, there's definitely a video of you shouting here by the mermaid. Just straight through the door.
The second one was worse. Remember, like, they had a massive shit, ran out of bog roll, went and got tissue out of my pocket, and then had to go again.
Do you want the beans, mate?
that's funnier than like a, that's a real kick. Like,
I was trying to get my phone out to get music on dead quick.
We were fucking killing ourselves at like how shaky your playlist was. Mickey would go from like fucking like Kasabian, like literally in the toilet, ring-a-gang-a-gang-a-gang-a-gang. And then the next one was like, I am whatever you say I am. And then it was like shuffle. Champagne soup and a, like it was just like
build me up.
The fucking the most insane combo of oh Jesus Christ.
Oh fuck yeah.
I was like, God, hey, Mick, give her snacks. And and then we fucking we bought a fucking, I literally thought we were about to get ripped off, because we went in and fucking we're like walk past this guy. He's like, are you okay, guys? And I was like, oh yeah, we're gonna go to the sex show. And he was okay, how many? And then we paid for it. And then he goes, okay, see that red line? You walk down there and it's on the left hand side. And I was like, ah, I'm just buying a ticket here and I have to walk the way down the street. Aye. So I walked the whole way down. And we eventually found it and went upstairs, and it was like a little tiny theater, wasn't it?
As soon as we walked in, I was going, "It'd be a great place for a show, like for a gig."
Yeah,
like an Edinburgh preview or something.
Yeah, it was like a really tiny little theater.
Walked in, there's two people bucking, and it was right at the end of their bucking bit, and then this curtain at this speed.
Yeah, it's like if you were doing a kid's puppet show, and they were like, "This is the end of it," and there's a guy going, and it very slowly comes around in a semicircle. And sometimes you can see them just quit before the fucking curtains really stop. But it was like
done their time, like.
And we sat for that, and it was just like, now see if we had been mic'd up for that 1 hour.
Fuck,
it was
me.
The fucking funniest.
Like
shit.
I couldn't hear what you were saying, right? But there was a point where I was actually feeling sorry for McCann, because he was in the middle of just me and you just fucking like
hitting him with jokes
constantly. Fucking like,
there was one girl come out, and she was blonde, right? Big girl, and very again, and they're always like in good athletic shape.
Oh yeah, cracking shit. Right? And that's all the big fake tits in the.
Yeah, she kept singing. She was singing 50 Cent, right? And she was
candy shop.
She looked like a dude. And I went to Aaron. I was like, "Is that 50 Cent?" And he goes, "Aye, the song, yeah." And I went, "No, is that 50 Cent with her face painted white?" And he fucking lost his shit. And then you were the girl with the beads pulling out of her fanny, and you were like, "Someone's blinds are closing somewhere."
But she was pulling the string out of her fanny, and I was going, "Bet you the fucking the bathroom lights were just going dun 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 dun."
It was so funny. And then like you know, there's
there was the bit with McCann, sorry, when there's a couple comes out, there's a guy and a girl bucking.
Oh my god, yeah.
And the angle your man was at, his balls are swinging out the back, and I went, "Look at his balls." McCann went, "Just like an old Jack Russell." And I swear to god, like I was going, I've never laughed like this in my life. I was going,
do you know what was even funnier though? It wasn't like the natural swing of his bollocks. Oh. She had a hold of his dick, and she was kind of giving it one of these. So his balls were doing a very like robotic, like this here.
Oh my god!
But it was like so funny. Meanwhile, there's one old Chinese guy who's about 90 at the front, and everything that happened, he's like, "Oh yeah, my god!"
He's going, "Ooh,
yeah, it's very nice." And then, fuck me, there was one girl wanted a bit of, like, audience participation, so she brings, like, three people up. This couple come in, both in black, big, tall black guy, and this fucking full-blown rap girl, rap video chick, and she goes on stage to play this banana game, where, like, the stripper will sit there with her fucking clunge wide apart, and you bite the banana, and she went first, and she just fucking...
Ripped half the banana off?
She just necked the banana, like, gung, and bit it off, and probably her fucking boyfriend in the crowd was just like, "Yeah, bitch, that's right."
Mm-hmm.
And she was, like, she had some hole on her.
I don't remember that, but I was still laughing at the fucking...
I can remember that. I actually said to Aaron, I was like, of all the women so far, I'm like, let's get her in the mix.
What was there... There was a point, though, because we were cracking jokes the whole way through, and there was a point where somebody came out...
There was one girl come out and she was absolutely banging. Like.
And everybody just went...
And I turned around and I was like, I'd fucking shut you up, didn't I? I'd fairly fucking quiet you down. Yeah, no. Some of them are like, you know, they're like... you know, like, oh, there's just some girl with her tits out. And then you're like, oh, here's, you know, some girl's a bit dirty looking. You know, a bit sort of porn star looking. And then one comes out and she's actually beautiful. And you're like, oh, fuck. Look at that. Isn't that a shame?
You shouldn't have to do this.
That's terrible.
She was unbelievable. Oh. That one. Everyone just went quiet and was like, yep.
Very, very funny though.
I'll take you to the fucking candy shop.
Oh, sure.
All right. And then fucking just came out of that, and I don't know what else. Fucking bullshit.
More sweets and all, wasn't it? More fucking.
Yeah, we went for.
Oh, we went for a sit down pizza, didn't we?
Yeah. That's when we were. I got very stoned again. I was out of my mind at that.
Because I know, yeah, there was a point used to when I first smoked, and I was like, I don't even think I can inhale anymore.
And the girl, there was like a hen, like the worst looking hen party of all time down at the other end of the restaurant. And there was about 12 of them, and they were about to leave. And she goes, by the way, we waited an hour and a half for our food. And we were like, all sort of like, oh, fuck that, boys. But so wrecked, we couldn't move.
Exactly.
I was like, sure, an hour and a half will pass quick enough.
I'd be starving by then anyway.
If we're sitting here just not moving. And then we just fucking ended up in some like, one of those like ice cream pastry shops.
There were fucking what a great idea! Like,
oh my god, such fat cunts! Like, it was the most. No one bucked anybody, and we all just couldn't handle the amount of weed we had.
And just ate delicious food for 2 days. It was glorious.
McCann got fucking churros, and he goes, "Oh, that's a panic order that's actually paid off for me." Because he told me about going on a date. He's probably talked about it in this podcast. He went on a date in America with a girl to a crepe place, right? Well, the review said it was crap anyway. but he said the menu was like about that thick. Every type, every variation of sweet and savory crepes you could get. And he panicked. And he goes, can I just get a plain crepe? And I'm like, you fucking psychopath. Like, but he goes, it was in this place. And he goes, a panic ordered the churros. And I swear to God, I was like, there are certain things you eat it and you go, people shouldn't be allowed that.
It was fucking delicious.
Churros with cinnamon and white chocolate sauce on it, and I was like, what the fuck? I know.
But we're eating ice cream at the same time, so it was like
fat cunts.
You're getting that fucking thing where like cold ice cream and then hot churros in your mouth. It's like, what the fuck is happening?
Yeah, and you're like absolutely out of your mind.
Fucking great trip. Can't wait to go back.
Couldn't feel myself from the waist down just eating churros, like brilliant.
I think I feel like shat my spine out when we go back to
Mickey, you feeling some discomfort? Yep. Questions? Not a question. Just make McCann eat 3 to 4 brownies. Is there a wheel? Oh, these are weird questions. If there's a wheelchair bound comedian, is it still called stand up? Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I've known one guy who did stand up in a wheelchair, and I do believe that was his first joke.
Yeah.
You know. P.S. You should definitely do the podcast stoned. Well, that was the idea, the but like I couldn't.
Sure, it's not legal in this country, so we can't do that.
I couldn't have functioned the fucking amount I took. But it's good to hear from people who are experienced in that field that we did, in fact, massively overdose on weed. We took what you would put in about fucking 8 bong rips.
Aye, and just fucking hoofed it.
Yeah, Jesus Christ. Question is, did you hear about the ma that booked an apartment in Belfast for her 16-year-old's birthday for her and her friends, and she put the invite out on Snapchat. Word got round, and a few no-gooders turned up and caused £40,000 worth of damage. Have you ever had a mad night go as bad as that? This isn't necessarily related to any of the shit we're talking about, but sure.
I know, I've definitely been to a few.
I was at a party once, and it was absolute chaos, and then, yeah, literally, I don't know if I've told this before. I've told you, I think. You know, your man David Jeffries that used to manage Linfield?
No.
His son, I think, went to my school. He was at this party, and we'd left the party, and I think his son got in a fight, and he rang his dad, and his dad arrived blocked with his mate, and we were the first people that we walked away. We were basically walking home.
Aye.
It was one of, you know, when you're like, a taxi would get us home in 10 minutes, but if we walk, it'll take us probably about an hour and a half.
Yeah.
So we just started fucking walking, and we were the first people he met on the street, and he was just like, who the fuck's kicking off? You know, like, thought we were in the fight with someone. We were like, what the fuck are you talking about? But this house was trashed, like fucking Project X cops.
Fucking hell.
People smashing, like, you know, those big giant plant pots that you get? Aye. Like fucking huge ceramic ones. It was a disaster, like.
Remember my cousin telling me, this is one of these fucking, my cousin told me it happened, but I do believe him, where he said he was at a party. Two of my cousins were at this party. One's outside smoking a joint. The other one came out and was like, one of the lads, and they're just fucking, like, happy slap me a wee, like, just fucking just fuck me about. So my other cousin was like, we'll go back in and fucking hit him. And he didn't think he was going to do anything. He said, yes, he smoked a joint. He looked through the living room window, and my cousin chokeslammed a fella through a table. Talk about overkill. Hit him back, don't kill him.
Yeah.
hit him a wee slap, you know what I mean? I actually did that in school. There was a guy like fucking, like, you know, that was like a thing, like fucking happy slapping someone. He like slapped me in the head and I pretty much dropped him with a slap.
Aye.
Like fucking, you know when you get a bit like, get a wee bit fired up, and I was just like, and he fucking hit the ground. He was like, did the wee quivery lip and all, and I was like, don't be slapping people, bitch. I weigh twice what you weigh. Fucking
I'm 15 and bald.
Yeah.
I've seen some shit.
Fuck. Put you through a wall, you can't. Dick. I was going to say something else. I forgot. Lord Firefox, currently have a three plant growing. Me one, but's me robot. Would you like me to send you a free sample when it's time to harvest? Man of many talents, me. He's growing weed. Yeah, send it away. Right. Fucking right, bro.
I'll call down to
him. Send the weed, boy. I must say, I do prefer the experience of vaping weed.
Yeah?
It's cleaner. It just seems like it's much more managed. It's very instant.
Aye.
Very instantaneous, so you feel it straight away. So you can just top it up as you see fit.
Aye.
You know, you do it. You do like two puffs, you go, I feel that now. And it doesn't really get worse or...
Aye, you could smoke a whole joint. It takes 20 minutes to kick in.
Yeah, you're like, what's happening? And then the next minute, your pizza's heavy.
No.
Yeah. Can you ask Aaron what's the craziest thing he's got stuck in his head, or got his head stuck in, asking for a friend? Well, he's not here now, so fuck him.
Right. A sombrero.
Is anyone heading to festivals or concerts in the summer? You doing Glasgow
I'm
or
doing
anything?
Doing Glasgow again this year.
Are you? Fucking good man. You're probably the best act on the lineup.
Fucking two shows this year, too. Boom. Give me money.
Give me that money.
So I had Glastonbury and then Edinburgh. Does that count?
Yeah, I suppose I have nothing planned.
No.
I'm going to Tenerife. See, you know, right?
They're like, especially with music festivals, especially with Glastonbury, like, it's one of those things where I've been three times now and I've always been like, fuck, I would love to be at home watching this.
Oh yeah.
Because you can't see the bands.
It's a bit like UFC or something, that if you want to actually see it,
stay in the house.
Watch it on TV.
Yeah.
But I don't know. Glastonbury's class. I would do it again if I could drive to it.
Yeah.
That's it.
I suppose if you're not... I drive... Well, I suppose because I'm gigging on it. You've got backstage car parking.
I would do it if I could do that. Aye. And it's a great festival that you can go in and out of. Like, there's a bus will take you to Tesco's and back with a fucking carry out.
Aye.
That's unbelievable.
Yeah. But it's fucking huge. Like, I didn't realise... First time we went, we just flew to Bristol and got a bus in. And I didn't realise how fucking big the normal campsite was until we were leaving on the Monday. And you're like, fucking shanty town. Like,
I've only been once, but I really fucking got a pretty sweet like spot, really. And it turns out it was a lot of the staff, a lot of people who worked at the actual event were camped in that same area. And we were right beside that like John Peel tent. You just went down there and then, you know, walked straight across to the main stage. It was, everything was quite handy.
Yeah.
You weren't like out in the fucking outskirts of anything, like. And it was near the door, which was good because I did a couple of beer runs to Tesco's as well.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. It's just a bit long. There's a few of those things where you're like, oh, we're going to have the time of our lives. And like, after about 2 days, you're like, I could definitely go home now. And then you have to really fucking psych yourself up for like another 3 days. Totally.
So that's even like, did you just get there on the Wednesday as well? When you went?
I can't remember, to be honest. But it was nearly a full fucking week. Like, we were there.
I've go Wednesday to Monday. And I'm like, fuck.
It's long, like. Were we in the airport at the same time?
On the way home, yeah.
Yeah. Fuck, I was such a dickhead. I was like, it's obviously going to be mucky. It doesn't matter if the sun's out. There's so many people. Everything you watch, it's so fucking mucky. I'm just bringing wellies. And I didn't bring any other shoes. I could have got away with a pair of fucking Converse the whole weekend. Yeah.
I said to anybody, if you go to music festivals, always bring... I bring like walking boots.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're waterproof and they're comfier than wellies. And you're going to be bogging. Even like people wear wellies up their fucking knee, you're still going to get fucking stinking.
Yeah.
But now your feet are sore. Although the last time we were there, the time before that was a washout. It was the year the Brexit vote came in, and we were going to try and walk up this big massive, do like the Glastonbury sign on the hill.
Yeah.
And I was like, standing holding 2 pints, talking to somebody. I was like, listen, here's the thing about walking boots. You can get up hills, no problem. Welly boots, there's no grip. And as I was saying it, I like went full horizontal and landed right in my face. Spilled 2 pints all over myself.
Cock.
And I was really enjoying the pints too. Do when you get up, it was like, do one of them pints, you go, fuck, that's one.
Yeah. Jesus Christ. I know, I think I got really blocked on the first night. Typical. And then the rest of the time, I couldn't get drunk.
Aye.
And I was like, fucking, I mean, we went to see Motorhead. And I'd emptied a bottle of whiskey into, like, you know, like a bottle of water where you just squirt the top, like, like that. And I drank the whole thing. And I was, like, sober as fuck.
The year we went where... So me and my ex-girlfriend...
Do you know what was popular that year? When everyone was doing those...
Like, all the way laughing at things?
Things. And there was... Oh, Jesus.
I remember that one year where... it was the Sunday, so we were going back on the Monday. And there was me and my ex were going to be, like, sort of splitting the driving. So we were like, you know what? I'm not even going to fucking drink today. Couldn't be ass drinking.
Yeah.
And then I went to see that band, Nathaniel Rateliff and the Night Sweats, because I fucking love them. And one of my mates said, I was like, mate, I'm going to go up here, see this band, so I'll meet you up in about 20 minutes. He said, by the time he got to the place, I was fucked. Son of a bitch! Give me a drink!
I know, it's fucking... There was one... I don't know whether I've talked about it or not. There was one moment at Glastonbury where I was like, everything came together at one time, and it was pissing down. And then the sun came out and it dried up everything so quickly. And we fired a load of beers into us and got some like really tasty food. And then Future Islands came on.
Uh-huh.
Do you know them, huh?
I think so.
They literally have like a fucking legendary set from that year. I bet you, hold on, it probably comes up here. Glastonbury. It was fucking unbelievable. But it was just like sunny and like... He's a fucking known lunatic, this cunt, like, but... We were over here somewhere.
Right.
But the sun had just come out and everything. I don't know, it was like proper...
Perfect, like...
Proper wee,
Was that, yeah, the weather was decent that year, because that was...
Festival fields. It just absolutely emptied once.
That's right, it did, yeah, I remember that.
And like Mary J. Blige was on or something, and I was like, why is she even here? Without slagging her to death.
Yeah, because it was that thing, because it was so dry, when it did empty, it was a swamp for about 40 minutes.
Yeah, it was hectic. They're fucking... It's not. It's weird because it's not my type of music at all, but they're very entertaining.
This song is a lonely last goodbye. Watch out, dance with us one last time, alright?
He's like...
It'll be fun, don't worry about it.
If Morrissey fucked the Joker.
Yeah.
I think the weather's just perfect for it, actually. I think the weather's just perfect for a good dance party right here and right now.
Seem hurtful to me.
The Brown Wisps? he's got shapes, though. Look at that cunt. Basically, I think what... They basically went viral.
Aye.
Because they were on Jules Holland, and he was dancing around like a fucking dickhead like this. And it was like millions of hits for some reason. But they've got good, like... Very weird, though. It's the weirdest fuck... It's like all we synthy music, and it's like...
Fucking can't wait to go now.
I know. I'm jealous. Right, let's rattle through these questions.
Gaskins.
When did you first smoke weed? Oh, my God. My neck.
Uni for me, I think.
Was it?
Yeah,
it's quite late.
Yeah, in fact, it was a night after we got in a fight one night.
I just had a fucking horrendous memory.
We got our head kicked in, and then it was the next night nobody could drink. So somebody procured, and the first time I smoked weed was my fucking blunt. And yeah, shit myself. Not physically.
I remember this guy lived on our street, and he was like, oh, you're mad. Oh, so fucking big. The guy was like about 16, probably like got it off his brother or something.
Aye.
And he's going, oh, mate I go to school with is going to bring us down blow. And I was like, are you serious? And he's like, oh, he's going to bring us blow. And this guy arrived, and you know in the summer you can get like whatever haircut you want?
Aye.
The guy had like a number 3 all over, and then someone had shaved like cornrows in his head. He literally like fucking James Franco in that fucking movie, whatever it is. He's got his head. And the guy had like fake cornrows, and he's like, I got the blow, mate. And then takes out what looks like a rabbit shit and was like, fucking have a good day, guys.
And I'm pretty sure we smoked it in a fucking, you know, just like you get a tin of Coke and just like stab holes. Oh, just put your whole mouth out like out there. Burn the lungs out of yourself.
There's nothing wrong with burning aluminium, which will be fine.
Taste the paint, the Fanta paint. But that was about it. And just fucking like, yeah, just fucking, I actually missed that because it was about the giggliest weed I've ever smoked. You know, wee bit of hash.
I still get the fucking like real serious giggles when I smoke weed. Like.
I do. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. Sometimes I just like, I just go to sleep, and then other times I'm like.
There was a night we smoked it and we're watching fucking RuPaul's Drag Race, and I was fucking glued to it. And then, did Maureen's Mag come in or something? Because it was before your wedding, so she's still talking all wedding shit, and I was just sitting in the corner like. We're in our 30s and I'm so afraid.
I love that shit. Yeah, we should definitely smoke more weed.
Weed in the night.
Smoke weed. Whilst you're in Amsterdam, you should check out... No, well, that's irrelevant now. Couldn't be happier about this combo. I'm definitely late to the NI comedy party, but I've been binging the podcast recently and loving it. Okay. There you go.
You're welcome.
Well, there you go. I mean, I feel like we didn't get a podcast done while we were there, but the one we did in Dailies, which is now available to listen to, will fill that gap a wee bit.
Without a doubt. I was laughing watching that one, and I was in it.
Did you watch it back?
Yeah.
Did you? Fuck, is there any funny bits I could cut out? Because I haven't watched it yet.
I can't remember. That's it was, do you know what? It was so fast paced. It was like,
that's a legit job someone needs to fucking do for me, is just go through the podcast and time stuff. Just be like, all right, here's the funny bits that you can take out as a clip. I'll never fucking watch them back. Like, unbelievable. How do you manage to have Lavery sell big tubes of Pringles for £2? Bro, I don't own the bar. So.
I don't know.
But like, it's easy fucking money, isn't it?
Aye. £2's a fucking decent price for it.
Well, that's what the guy said. Do you put them on, or does the bar, obviously the bar, consider just me emptying fucking boxes of Pringles out of the back of the car? That's why I bought the estate, you see.
Got that mic stand there, Colin? Fuck. We'll go back to the house.
Considering it's £1.50 for a small downstairs. Lovely snack whilst watching the acts, and then some left for the drive home. Perfect. This is like the best fucking like review ever. Yeah. What's the most expensive convenience snack you've ever paid for, ignoring your own rationale, like a hungover craving at an airport, etc.?
Fuck. I mean, narrow that down. Do you know what
I mean? I would say for most people, it's probably if you got a Domino's and it wasn't like a 2 for Tuesday.
Aye.
And you're like, oh yeah, I'll pay £47 for 3 pizzas.
Yeah, I did once order a pizza in a hotel. Convinced myself that I'd fucking given the wrong room number.
Yeah.
Realized it was too late for room service. Ordered Domino's. And as soon as I ordered the Domino's, the pizza arrived from the hotel. And I couldn't cancel it, and I've just sat in a hotel room with 2 full pepperoni pizzas.
Oh, you fat hoe.
Doing a proper, like, wonder how much I can eat.
Oh my God. Yeah, now the thing about it, it's definitely been, like, probably room service.
Yeah,
I can remember we were in Thailand, and it fucking pished down. Like, to the point where it was like, you can't actually do anything. It's like fucking, like, a storm. And I knew you could get this pork rice, like, on the fucking street for next to nothing, but I was ordering it in the hotel and it was like cost a fortune.
Aye.
But it was so fucking tasty. I was just like, in fact, I'm pretty sure one night I just ordered 2 of them, which is so fat cunt.
I've had a couple of nights where I've cleaned out a mini bar, but just the sweets and. Yeah. And you look at the price in the morning, you go, I spent £37 going to bed last night.
Oh, fuck's sake. Unbelievable. How many loads of bread does McCann's head weigh? Fuck knows what his head. What do you think? This is not related to anything, but it's funny. What do you think of how the Remora rat was dealt with?
Oh, is the one that jumped the rat? I haven't seen the video yet, actually, but from what I've heard, it's like, it's a rat.
Yeah, it's a rat. I don't give a fuck.
Do you know what I mean?
Also, I'm not surprised that there is a rat, because it's the fucking, it's beside a harbour.
Aye.
Oh
no.
And we're back with a minor battery fault there. Bastard.
What a joke. We're smoking weed.
Podcast question. Will you ever do a gig in Uri again? Hopefully not.
I'm doing Uri on Saturday night. It's funny how our careers have gone in such different directions, Colin. You with your arena, me the bank in Newry.
No, maybe an alright gig. Who fucking knows?
The grand, I'm a genius.
What's the weirdest thing you've thought whilst high on the devil's lettuce? Definitely that I might accidentally kill myself.
Yeah.
What's this? Christ. What's your thoughts on Joey Diaz? You seem similar in style. Do we?
Science.
Cocksucker. I think he's amazing. He's
fucking hilarious.
I mean, I'll be honest. I said this before. I was pleasantly let down by the standard at the Comedy Store.
Yeah.
Like, nothing fucking blew my mind, really. Apart from him. There was a few people I was like, Jesus Christ, he's...
dog shit, like,
yeah, terrible. Yeah. And there was a few surprised me, like Joe Rogan was, I was just like, what? Chris D'Elia, who I love Chris D'Elia's fucking, yeah, podcast and all, but his stand-up is dirt. And then like, who the fuck did we see? Like Bobby Lee was hilarious. There was a guy called, I forget his fucking name now, Eleanor Kerrigan or something. Have you ever heard of her?
No.
Actually, she might be going out with your man Andrew Dice Clay. She was hilarious. Joey Diaz was fucking hilarious too. But he was the only one where, like, me and Aaron were like, and I'm like killing ourselves. Aye. Not just like, ha ha ha, like proper pissing ourselves laughing. And I don't know whether it was because you know him and you know what he's like. But, and I'll tell you what.
I think he is. Like, I mean, if you
ever, but I'll be honest, the first, say, like, he's doing 15 minutes. The first 5 minutes, I was like, ah, oh, he's not that fucking funny either.
Aye.
And then he just, out of nowhere, obviously, like, was like, this is so pedestrian. And he went from like, duh, 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 my mother, fucking whatever. And then he just went in, they're like, do you ever eat fucking pussy with a fucking fuse hanging out of it? And it's like, he just went not the 60 on the dirt. Like, and we were dying. Like, and then there was one other guy and a whole, in the main room of the Comedy Store, like the whole night, a guy called Michael Costa or something.
I've heard that name.
Come rip the place apart. Like, hello. And Steve Ranzisi, lethal.
Aye.
But the most of them were shite.
Yeah. I'd say when I was in New York, I didn't even go to any of the fucking comedy clubs in New York.
That guy,
Andrew. I get too jealous watching stand-up.
Yeah. That guy, Andrew Schultz, is a fucking animal too. If you watch much of his.
Bits and pieces of
him. He just, I can't warm to him as a character or as a person, like, but the bits are just like, I can't believe that idea was just on the table the whole time.
Aye.
Where the fuck do you pull that from? But like, he was doing a bit about, and it just seemed like a wee throwaway bit about like women's grooming. About them, it was like, you're putting eyelashes on your fucking eyelashes. Because there's no dude has ever been like, I wasn't gonna fuck her, but have you seen the extra eyelashes, dude? And then he goes on about, like, he goes, he had a roommate who like fucking waxed everything, and then he goes, but she bleached her mustache, and he goes, I don't think it's the color is the issue. And he goes, you just have a blonde mustache, like fucking like Hulk Hogan or something. And I was like, oh, so good. But he's such a cock, like, but very, very funny.
Brilliant. Might watch him on the way home in the car. Not
oh, he's there, but there is fucking so much material. Yeah. Like, he does a thing where you just put up a clip like every week.
Oh, good.
And I think it's just like a wee. But I mean, he is the business model at the minute.
Yeah.
Put up stuff that's like relevant, because especially in New York, if you can gig every night, put up something that's relevant and a bit edgy, and it does the rounds. And he's basically made himself into like a viral stand-up.
Yeah.
It's very impressive, but he is a bit of a knob. Like, name this trio. What would you call me, you, and Aaron as a team? The Soda Boys. I made that up before for like a fake rap group. Soda Boys.
Two men, a bit of gravy.
The meat faced.
Yeah.
The big meat treat. Meat sale.
The deluxe Big Mac. I'm starving now.
I know. Fuck, I'm hungry.
Stuffed crust.
Are there no tickets left for the SSE show in January? Needed more, and I only see disabled section tickets left.
That's fucking, I'm very happy for you.
Well, I actually,
there's plenty left for the Ulster Hall.
I actually had to speak.
I said plenty.
I actually had to speak to the promoter and be like, why are people saying you can't buy tickets? And he goes, no, you can. They've been selling away today. And I was like, well, what's happening?
Aye. Fucking crashing, because you seem to be
going on and you can't see the seats that are you're buying. Looking back, is there anything you would have wanted to know when you were starting comedy that you know now? Just that you don't need anybody else. That's what I would have.
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
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 Like, stop trying to fucking wait around for a thing to click or a thing to happen or someone to notice you, because you actually don't need any of them.
Yeah. And yeah, steal, definitely. I think like
and steal because you know what's anyone gonna do about it?
Steal,
steal all around you.
Aye, food, jokes. Yeah, probably right because I think like we started. Well, for me anyway, stand up. I started stand up at a weird time in that it was just when the traditional way of doing things had stopped.
Yeah.
So for a good 5 or 6 years where I was like, I'll just do this with you thing on TV and then somebody will see me do this and then I'll be this and then...
Yeah.
You realize there's a million concert fucking... A million killers you'll never hear of.
100%. DIY, guys. Do it yourself.
That's it.
Most culty thing you've seen in Amsterdam, apart from Mickey and the west side of McCann's Dome.
There was that guy that... In the ice cream shop, wasn't... He wasn't really culty, he wasn't.
We were just sitting eating a fucking... By the way, coffee ice cream, I would lick out of a tram stand.
I got the salted caramel and it was like frozen cum, but I liked it.
But some guy just leans his head in and goes, get her, buck! I was like, you cannot take these people anywhere.
Definitely not.
Fucking tramps.
Definitely not.
Get her fucking buck! Oh, Jesus wept now. I think that might be the last question, boys. That's the last question. I hope that in some way made up for the fact that we didn't do a podcast in Amsterdam. But I feel like we wouldn't have been concentrating.
Aye.
You know, this podcast, when you hear this, there are a few ones in the pipeline, I think. I'm going to put one out on my own. And then I have the Hunk Papa one.
Oh, yeah, that'd be good.
Available. And the one that I did... with all three of us, is available across all platforms as we speak. So it is. The Hunk Papa one's a disaster. Like four lads holding mics, so it's like...
Oh, really?
And then I fucking... they were basically like, oh yeah, before you upload that, can we possibly edit some bits out of that? And I was like, why? And they're like, oh, it's just I think we might ruin our careers if we say some of the things that we had said previously. And I was like, well... You can do it, because I ain't editing shit.
Aye. Tough telly, Hunk Papa.
Hunk Papa. Right, let's get the fuck out of here.
Let's do it.
Cheers, Micah.
Cheers, Colin.
Oh, I just took my yellow glasses off.
By the way, can I plug a gig real quick?
No.
No,
go for it.
13th of May, if you're in London, I'm going to be doing an Edinburgh preview in the Bill Murray. Tickets should be available first thing in the morning. So we've got 2 weeks and we'll try and fucking pack out a wee place in London. So if you know anybody wants to come down, hear me talk some smut, it'd be great to see you.
There we go. And Mickey's paying 30% of his gig in advertising space. The podcast, so it's good.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Why don't you do a podcast? Tell me again one more time.
Not very good at it. not very good. And,
I just don't think you find your niche.
Don't like being left in a room with my own thoughts. so what I'd like to do is just come down and do yours, and this is also my way of getting out of the house, and the only time during most days that I let go of my own cock.
Just gonna get a bit of air around the palm.
The fucking calluses. You deadlift, Mick? Not to tell.
With one hand? Fuck off.
Dick's got a bend in it.
Is there a bend in your dick?
Used to be. I corrected it. Started going left.
I was sleeping on it wrong.
There's a roundabout in it.
Mickey's doing a guy's cauliflower dick. Go fucking sideways.
Cauliflower cheese.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Mine's just straight.
Isn't just straight, eh?
Those curvy dicks that go up the way and everything.
Mine used to curve.
Mine just goes out like that. Like a bird could sit on it.
But I think one side was maybe fatter than the other, and then it's evened itself out. I have to look at it again, I don't know. Might have a photo on my phone here.
Right, on that note, see you next
week. All the best. Cheerio.
Take care of yourselves.
And each other.
Yes.